to this. That this trial is just going to do what it does. But I'm not going to give it any fuel. I'm not going to give it any energy. I'm not going to give it any power. Why? Because I'm going to stand.
Yes.
Because the Bible says that we had already been chosen before the foundation of this world.
Yes.
And if you've already been chosen before the foundation of this world, then guess what? Every trial that you're going through has already been chosen before you even knew your name.
I know that's right.
Yeah. God already knew that you were going to go through it. He already knew the heartaches that you were going to have. He already knew the tests and the problems that you were going to. He already knew, because he's a God that knows all things.
Yeah.
Yeah. He knows it all. That's why we have to prepare ourselves to be ready for what comes. See, God knows it. We just don't know.
Yeah.
So since I don't know it, I got to prepare myself so that when the storm comes.
Come on.
See, the meteorologists, they will begin to tell us about storms. They'll tell us about various things that are about to happen. And they give us that warning that we might prepare ourselves for what's about to come. Well, we've got a warning already that the enemy desires to sift you as wheat.
Come on.
And since we've got the warning already, now it's time for us to prepare ourselves. He said, arm yourselves like one.
Yes, Lord.
Put on the whole garment of praise.
Yes.
Yeah. You are more than a conqueror.
Yes, we are.
We are a part of God's royal family. Everything, and everything that belongs to Jesus, it belongs to you.
Mom.
Everything that he has, it's yours.
Yes.
Sometimes we forget. We look at our present situation and forget that we're still rich. Yeah, you may not have that bread for that sandwich right now. And say, man, I'm so broke, I can't even get a slice of bread. Well, what you know, you're still rich.
Come on now.
Because if you can take the time to think about where you're at. See, a lot of times we lie to ourselves. We lie. We say, man, I don't got nothing here to eat. You're lying.
That's true.
You're lying.
That's true.
You're lying to yourself. What you mean to say, I'm too lazy to go in there and cook something.
Come on, that's true.
Because you have something to eat. See, if you take the time to think about those that are in Africa and other countries, they don't have nothing to eat.
Yeah.
But you have something to eat. We've got to stop speaking these things over our lives.
That's right.
We've got to stop speaking it. You know, this year, one of the things I did was put a dollar in my wallet. And all year, I didn't touch it. I didn't touch it because I refused to declare over my life that I was broke.
Amen.
So what would happen is every time I thought, I got a dollar, I'm not broke. See, we got to learn how to switch some things.
Uh-huh.
The Bible said, be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. And see, when you learn to do that, guess what? You'll find that you really are broke. Uh-huh. So I started saving the dollar because I didn't want to say that I was broke. But tonight, in that same wallet, I have $200.
Oh, well.
Because I kept adding a dollar when I had an extra dollar. I said, I'm not going to spend this dollar. I'm going to save this dollar. Because why? I don't want to decree that I'm broke.
Yes.
And not only that, I said, God, I want you to train me and to teach me to hold on to something.
That's right.
The reason why a lot of us broke, because we can't hold on to it.
That's
but I'm expecting
right.
Great things in 2018 that you can hold on to.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're predestined
Come on.
To make it. Hell is not fighting you because of who you are, where you are now, or what you have now. Hell is fighting you because you're about to become something great.
That's right.
Hell is fighting you because he understands and sees that God has something great for you in store.
Yes.
That's why you're going through the hell.
That's right.
You're not going through what you're going through just because of sin. You're going through what you're going through because you have a great destiny that is about to come.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. People are not going through anything And there's some people that have gone through some of the same things that you've gone through this year, and they didn't make it.
Come on.
They didn't make it. Many, if we take our time even now and think about over the year, we'll think about those who we lost. Not just physically death, but I'm talking about mentally, physically. Because why? They made some choices that you made as well. But because God had a plan for you.
Yes.
Because God had something designed for you. He didn't suffer it to be.
To be so. Thank you, Lord.
That's enough for us to give God praise.
Amen.
See, a lot of times, the only time we can praise God is when we get the things that we think we want.
Say it.
But if I can learn to praise God for allowing me to yet be in my right mind.
Say it.
If I can praise God to yet have the activities of my life. See, Brother Torrance said something today. He said that when he goes to his job, he said people would go, and there's some folks that are going to their jobs, and before they get in the parking lot, they already got a headache.
Yeah.
Because they're going to the job because they don't want to go. But every time I go to work, I'm excited.
I know that's why.
Every time I go to work, I'm not.
Yeah.
And I'm excited.
I am.
And I said, God, I thank you.
Yes.
Because there's somebody that's at home in the bed that don't have a job.
Don't have a job.
Come on, but God, you blessed me to get up and go to work.
Yes.
God, I thank you because you are a supplier of all my needs.
Yes.
So, got to learn why we go through the things that we go through.
Yes.
No trial is easy. But victory is great.
Yes.
I can't have victory without a trial. Mm. You can't have greatness until you've suffered. For the Bible said that after you've suffered a while.
Come on.
He said, then shall you come out as pure gold. Yes. You can't become gold until you suffer.
Come on.
Is there anybody tonight that got some battle scars?
Yes, sir.
Is there anybody tonight that got some wounds that you see now that God has healed?
Yes, yes.
Israel could not enter into a wealthy place until they understood what it was to be poor.
Come on, come on.
You've got to understand what it is not to have anything.
Come on.
So then when you do get something, you can be thankful.
Come on.
That's why David said, I will bless the Lord
at all
times.
Yes.
See, Joseph, it wasn't just that his brothers hated him, that they sent him to the pit. But what happened was they seen what Joseph was about to become. They didn't want to receive the dream that he had.
Yes, Lord.
They didn't want what he was saying. They didn't want it to come to fruition. Because down deep inside, they already knew that what he spoke was going to come to pass.
Come on.
So they thought that if we put him in the pit, if we get rid of him, then it's not going to come to pass. I want you to know tonight, there's some folks that are trying to stop your blessings. But I want you to know they can't stop what God already has in the Word.
Come on now, it's working. That's well.
It may seem like right now, I'm in the pit. But I want you to know that you're on your way to greatness.
Yes.
Because why? I'm expecting that. And I love the word expecting.
Yes.
See, expecting means I'm looking for it.
Yes, sir.
Expecting means I know that it's coming.
Yeah.
You got to understand, I'm expecting this to happen. Expecting means that I'm being blessed on purpose.
Yes.
It's not about an accident that God's about to bless. Why? Because I'm expecting to get what he has.
Yes, sir. Anticipate.
Where the things are coming.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Your destiny is greater than every disaster that you've gone through. This year has been trying for many of us.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
As I heard you talk and I've heard you speak and I heard you say the various things that, yeah, we went through some slopes and we went through some valleys, but God was a man that promised us that he was going to take us through.
Yeah.
For the Bible said that he's not a man that he should lie, neither son of man should he repent. Yeah. If he said it, will he not perform it?
Yeah.
Will he not do it? That's why all of your appointed time, you got to wait.
Yes, sir.
Don't give up in the battle, but say, I'm going to stand right here. I'm not going anywhere.
Yes, sir.
Until he blessed my soul.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah. Satan's greatest fear is your tomorrow. That's his greatest fear. Because he sees that you succeeded today, but you got now a tomorrow to defeat him even more. Yeah. Gotta thank God and praise God for my tomorrow. Because why? The devil don't want you to see your tomorrow. So he wants to try to kill you right here. He wants to try to, he wants you to die out right where you are. He wants you to stop in the midst of your trial, to stop in the midst of your test. Because he knows that if I can stop you right here, that you won't get to your room tomorrow and to receive what God has.
That's right.
Yeah. We got to go where God's about to take us. The attack is not on you, but the attack is on your reward.
Yes.
The attack is on your future of what God has for you. But we've got to stand on the promises. Pharaoh tried to kill out Moses. Had he killed out Moses, no doubt the children of Israel would not have made it to the promised land.
True.
Because he could have stopped it before it got to where it needed to be. Some of us, even before we got to the age where we are, the devil tried to kill you before you got to where you are.
Amen.
I remember when we were about to have our son. And I remember of them saying to us, you need to abort him. They called us early one morning, early in the morning. It was scary. And told us we need to come to the hospital. The doctor wanted to see us in his office. It's like 7 a.m. Who call you at that time of morning? So we're young and we're scared, nervous, not knowing what's up. And we go. And then they begin to give us the news. And they begin to tell us that if you bring forth this child, that you're going to have to care for him for the rest of your life. Begin to talk about all the problems that he was going to have. And the doctor said to us, looked at us, and said that it was best that we abort him. Because we were young. And we could have more children. Ooh. But because we learned as children how to pray.
Come on, sir. I know that's right.
We learned as children how to believe and trust God.
That's it. That's it.
Because we learned and fell in love with the God of the Bible.
Yes, sir. Yes,
we
sir.
Heard what the doctor said, and yes, it bothered us.
Yes, sir.
Yes, it wasn't, it didn't feel good.
Yeah.
But we began to pray.
Yes, sir.
And not even knowing much, we said we got to get another opinion.
Yes, sir.
Thank God for insurance.
Amen.
Called one of the greatest doctors that were here in the state of Indiana.
Amen.
At the university in Indianapolis.
Yes, Lord.
We called up the doctor, just some young black folks living on the west side of town.
Yes, Lord.
But we said we want an appointment.
Yes, sir.
We want to show you these what the doctor has said to us. And we need to get your professional opinion. We were going to go to Indianapolis, but the doctor came to us.
Yes, he did.
Came to us.
Yes, he did.
She. Mm-hmm. And she came to us.
Yeah.
And so, when she came, she had already reviewed all of the work.
Yeah.
And after she reviewed everything, she said to us, well, I want you to know that what your doctor said is true.
It's true.
She said, yes, based on what I'm looking at, all of these things are going to happen. She said, but there is a 1% chance.
Come on, sir. That's all we need.
That he'll be born with none of these problems.
Come on, sir.
Well, that's all I needed, because the Bible said that if you have the faith, the size of a mustard seed.
Yes, sir. Yes,
but you can say to the mountains in that life, be the room.
Yes. That's it.
We believe God.
Yes, sir.
We begin to trust God.
Yes.
And even being young folks, we only wanted folks that knew how to pray and touch
us. That's right. I know that's right.
We didn't need it.